Today, Rosh Chodesh Mar Cheshvan, and as it is known, is a month in which we don't have festivals. This is really Mar Cheshvan, like a bitter one. Now, in Jewish history, a lot of things really happen on this time. Scorpio. And we'll see, as I wrote in my book, Above the Zodiac. And this is a book which really shows Jewish astrology through the Hebrew letters with which the world was created. As I wrote in many books of mine, if you follow, that really all the world tends to do with Hebrew letters. Because the Hebrew letters were the basis of creation, so therefore stars, zodiacs, elements, all were created with letters. There is a lecture which I gave about the letters, showing the relationship of each one to the star, to the zodiac, to the planet, to the element. In fact, the basis is the 22 letters of the alphabet. So each letter was used for something else, like Aleph was used for the air, Mem, similar to Maim, the water, Shin, fire. Now the earth, the element of earth, combined of everything. Then we showed also now the letters which have dots in it, like Dagesh in Hebrew. There are really 7 of them, Beget Kaporet. Those letters were found in the Bible, also in language, can be sometimes soft pronunciation like vet, fei, but also hard ones like bet, pei, definitely. So those are 7 letters basically, which are bet, gimel, dalet, kaf, pei, resh, taf, like beget, kaporet, like in Hebrew. It's like cover and a garment which are covering, like the stars are covering the real head sense of the world. It is according to the Book of Formation that with each letter planets were created. It means the 7 planets that we can see with our eyes. There are more, definitely. As we have today, Pluto, Saturn, certainly we can see, but others, Neptune, we cannot see. What we can see are the 7, and these are letters with which they were created. Bet, Saturn, Gimel, Jupiter, Dalet, Mars, Kaf, the Sun, Pei, Venus, Resh, Mercury, Taf, the Moon. There is explanation definitely for it. And this is what we spoke in our previous lectures. And then we have, after using 3 for the elements, 7 for the planets, so we are remaining with 12 ordinary letters, like the A, Vav, Zayin, Chet, Tet, Yud. So those letters, A was Aries, and Vav for Taurus, Zayin for Gemini, Chet for Cancer, Tet for Leo, Yud for Virgo. Then afterwards we have the Nun for this month, Scorpio, then comes Samech for Kislev, Sagittarius, then the Ein for Capricorn, then we carry on up to Capricorn. We have Shvat, Aquarius, the letter Tzadik, and the last one is the letter Kof, which is Pisces. Definitely, if you look in my book, you will see exactly the connections, the meaning of the letters, and definitely understanding deep the idea of astrology, what each star represents, the effect. In fact, as I mentioned, the greatest astrologist from New York Times, known as basically, his name appears in his books and over the clock, Sidney Omar, but his real name is Zeli Kimmelman. He's a confessor, he's a Jewish. He was very happy to see my book and to realize how much astrology and Judaism goes together. And this is definitely something which had a great impact on him. Then, afterwards, definitely confessing to me that he's Jewish, he put mezuzah on his door, and his life changed. He passed out and died as a Jew. But this is important. People, as he himself told me, that he did not know at all, and he thought rabbis told him, don't deal with astrology, it's nothing to do with Judaism. It is a great mistake. So when he met me, when I gave a lecture in Santa Monica, Los Angeles, so he saw my book, and he met me, we sat together, we spoke about Jewish astrology, and really had a great impact in his life. He told me it changed all his life. So definitely, this is, if you read my book about the Zodiac, it's available in my site, glazerson.com. Also, you can get it in also amazon.com. But this is a book that will really open your mind to see that people don't realize the riches and the wealth of knowledge that we have in our books. So, let us speak now about the month, the zodiac of Scorpio, according to the book of formation related to Abraham. Now, what we have in the book? So, let us really start at the beginning, which is very important. As we mentioned, that every month was formed by a letter. So, the month of Cheshvan, Scorpio, according to the book of formation, was formed by the letter Nun. And also the book of formation brings the nature of each month, and it says that the nature of this month is expressed in the sense of smell, and its sign is Scorpio. Now every month really has different kind of what we call attribute or sense. In the month of Scorpio had the sense of smell. It's very interesting. The sense of smell is very spiritual, by the way. And it represents really very high and deep ideas, as we'll see later. Also, the letter Nun is a very important letter. It represents a full understanding, because we have 50 gates of understanding, and the letter Nun equals 50. So this itself shows that this is a month of really, of understanding. Then, if you carry on also, we have to know what the Ari says, definitely Kabbalah, Abai Zikluya, goes together, definitely refers also to Zodiac and stars. So according to Zahari, there is a tribe for each month. Like we have 12 tribes in Jewish. We know 12 tribes, Reuben, Shimon, or Judah. And we know that they were in the desert in a certain order, right? 3 in the east, 3 in the west, 3 in the south, 3 in the north. And this itself already shows the direction that they are in. Also, an idea. So, according to the Ari, Rabbi Zikluya, the tribe of this month is Menashe. Now, it is very interesting that in our history, if you go through history, if one knows, so the most important event of this month was completion of construction of the Temple of Solomon, King Solomon. As it is written, it is written in the Bible, Kings, Melachim, Kings 1, 6, 38. So there is written clearly, in the month of Bul is definitely to do with the month of Taurus, the 8th month from Nisan, the house was completed. But, as we just now see, that because correspondingly, according to the Midrash, the third temple will be rededicated during the months of Cheshvan, of Scorpio. So it is very interesting The idea is that just as the tabernacle was completed during the month of Kislev, and its dedication was 4 months later, as you know, Nisan, during Nisan, and then the same thing also with the Temple of Solomon. It was completed during the month of Cheshvan, Scorpio, but the dedication was, interesting, 11 months later, in Tishrei, the third temple. We hope definitely it will be like this. So it is very interesting that the future, this is what is written, that the future third temple is symbolized in Hebrew word for the sign of Scorpio. Interesting, Scorpio in Hebrew is Akrab. Now we know that every word can be split into letters. So basically, if you take the word Akrab, you have 2 expressions. So you have Ikar, Aleph Kufra is the main one, and Bet in Hebrew is Bait. So the main house, which is really the third one, will be built in the month of Scorpio, month of Cheshvan. So hoping that it will be already, that we have the third man, the third temple this month, but who knows, if Jews will deserve it, because to deserve the temple, you have to keep Torah, Shabbos, definitely the Torah, and so we might miss the time, but it is very interesting that this is important month. Yeah. Now, what is really very, very important to know that Hebrew letters, Hebrew words, normally have positive and negative. Yeah. Because this is a free choice. So it is so interesting that the book, we should call Bnei Yisachar, he says that the Hebrew word Akrab, Scorpio, this is Akrab, but the letters, the word itself, can be positive one and can be very negative one. It means that, as we saw before, it can be Akrab, can be Ikar Bait, the most important house, which is a temple, the third temple, but it can be also Akar Bait, can be also destroying, Lakor, to uproot the house. And really what happened on this month, in this month, the flood happened. The flood destroyed the world because of the corruption of the people at that time. So this is Ikar Bait, this is Scorpio. And hoping that we'll have the positive one, Ikar Bait, the main house from all the 3 houses, definitely the third one that we need now urgently. So interesting, as we said, this is a month that really in history the flood took place in this time and destroyed the world. And hoping there will be Ikar Bait that we'll have the third temple on this month. Now, going on into the idea of this month, positive and negative, also it shows about people also. You know, people also definitely has to do with Hebrew letters, associated with letters, and therefore it can teach us also about character of people, what really happened to these people. So definitely what we see is a general idea of people born on this month, because in order to know exactly, you have to see the hour they were born, the place. What I give you here is general one, which is really according to the zodiac, the general zodiac, you know, of the sun. So what you will have here might not be exactly fits you, but it is also general. So according to the science of astrology, one born under the influence of the sun Scorpio has an extremely powerful emotional sensitivity and equally power of natural inclination. This is what they say. Yeah, I said because the letter Nun, also, by the way, positive and negative, can 50 gates of understanding, of purity.
but also 50 gates of impurity, unfortunately. So therefore, it is interesting that the science of astrology speaks about the sign of Scorpio, an extremely powerful emotional sensitivity, an equally powerful natural inclination. So this feature, if not used properly, according to the Torah, may lead one to the depths of depravity. However, on the positive side, a person with such powerful sensitivities has the ability to penetrate directly to the deepest appreciation of values, and if one's will is so directed, one may achieve a deep understanding of the Torah. Very interesting, yeah. So, negative side of this month, very dangerous. And positive, one can get a lot. So it is very interesting that also these things for us, for Jewish people, is really teaching us how to behave, what to do. So the divine service of this month, what really one should put emphasis on this month, so the divine service of this month is one's full acceptance of the decrees of heaven revealed in the Torah. This calls for appreciation of the awesomeness of heaven through such contemplative means, symbolized by the letter Nun, as we said, understanding, pointing to the 50 gates of purity and understanding. It's obvious. One may be delivered from the evil and destructive associated with the mouth. Very interesting. With the mouth. So, very important months, as we said, very highly things which one can achieve this month, or if not, misusing. And as we mentioned, every month have element, and the month of Cheshvan is urine, is water. I mean, water represent from one side of the Torah. Yeah, water. Or you call some elohu lamaim, you are thirsty, go to water of the Torah. The water of the Torah will save you, give you life, will save you, will purify you. What water are doing? But in the negative way, water represents lust. Yeah, lust, because everything to do with lust have to do with water. So definitely people this month indicate to this also idea in a negative way. So, as we said, the letter Nun of this month, the element of this month, water, as every month has an element, and, by the way, the planet of this month is Mars. Mars. So Mars also, you know, is the heavenly body which influenced this month. And we know that Mars is associated with the principle of stern judgment, also a symbol of wars. You know, this month. So the judgment visited upon the world by the flood arose as a result of the world's misuse of the power of desire and lust, which is rooted in the element of water. Yeah, because they sinned. Lot of lust, lot of negative water. So this brought the water of the flood to destroy them.
Also, the same thing happened with fire. Misusing fire also brings disasters which are to this fire. Don't need to relate it to what is going in California. But unfortunately, we know that Hollywood supplied a lot of movies which really strengthen last very much. Who knows if those fires that we have now and before is not a result of this behavior, no, homosexual, all this kind of last misused misuse of fire, fire is also lust. And who knows, maybe we should try now to stop homosexualism, to stop all other things, yeah, to do this lust. Maybe the fire will stop. Yeah, because it cannot be coincidence, such fires, yeah, which burn so many places. And you know, in the previous one, that really quite few houses affected, so they'll be burned. So, something to think about. This is the month of Cheshvan. So, this pollution of the water element brought about the repulsion of this element. Right? Very, very important ideas in this month. And we know about the generation of the flood. The Torah tells us the generation of the flood was, according to our sages, potentially fit for the receiving of the Torah. Amazing. This is what the Midrash says, that this generation, right, potentially was fit for the receiving the Torah. And the rendition of its deepest secrets, they deserve it. However, due to their sinfulness, they transform the blessed waters of the Torah, wisdom, into grace, to the bitter water of sin. Yeah? That's why really going into it and trying understanding properly. It is very interesting, as we said before, about the letter of this month, Cheshvan, even if you take the letters Cheshvan in Hebrew, because those letters also has meaning. So the letter that forms the name Cheshvan are close to those that form the word Cheshbon. Because we know in Hebrew the letter Vav and Bet come from the same source of letters, like Bumav, yeah. So the Bet changed with Vav. So Bezer Cheshvan is exactly the same letters like Cheshbon, which means accounting, making a clear accounting whose root is the power of initial through form in the soul, whose resting place is in the mind. Interesting, right? So it's a time to make really account, proper account, soul account about your behavior, understand, yeah, what sin can cause to. Yeah. This is important, yeah, to make account, as is written, mitzvah keneged mitzvah, realize that sins are destroying the world, like the flood, and mitzvot, keeping the Torah, is building the world. So, this is very important. As I said, that this element of this month, which is water, is exactly in a clear association with catastrophic flood, when the water destroys the world. Right? Misuse of water. God gave us the water to live, to bring children, to be fruitful, to fill the world. And what they are doing with this? Racing, homosexual, all other things, exactly against the intention of God. God created the world to have people, yeah? To marry, and a great mitzvah to be fruitful, to bring children, and not to destroy the seed which was given to man to build. And this is exactly why the flood came. Yeah, because exactly what was there, homosexuality was there, and misused the power which God gave to create, to do, to build. Yeah, who knows what is going today? To think about it, yeah, very important. So, in fact, if you look in my book, man, about the zodiac, you can read much, much more about many zodiacs, because there's so much behind Hebrew letters. One letter, you can write a whole book about it. In fact, I wrote a book about number 6, the letter Vav. About Nun also, one can write a lot, Nun, you know, in Nun in a positive way, can bring a lot of light. Yeah, Nun time, I say the Nun time, taken from the Nun, you know. Many English words are taken from Hebrew, and I brought my book, Hebrew Source of Language, can see it in Hebrews also language, my site, GrizzlesonBooks.com or Amazon. And I really prove that many, many English verses are taken from Hebrew, which was a source of all languages. There are some universities in the state which already agree that I was right. This is Isaac Mosesson, and develop it much more from academic point. I try to show it more from Kabbalistic point. So it's very, very important. So, interesting lecture. It is a part. I said, much more you should see in my book. And this is really kind of part, small part from this idea, but one should go into it and really will have a full sight of Jewish history. Astrology, like we said, Sidney Omar, who really, his life changed, he told me when he saw my book. He knew a lot about astrology. I did not know that all what he knows has much more meanings if you know Hebrew, and he knew Hebrew, because he learned in a cheder in Poland. Only when he wanted to deal with astrology, so the rabbi told him, leave it away. But after seeing what, and you know that he was this one who told Kennedy, don't go to Dallas. I seen the stars that you are going to be killed, be murdered. This is known story, it was in the paper at that time. So he knew what astrology is, and he was so happy to see something he did not know, that so much of it really had much deeper and full meaning and understanding in Hebrew. So important book, as I said. Okay, all my books are really to do with Hebrew letters, using Kabbalah, everything, because everything is really based on Hebrew letters, with which the word was created. As the first verse in Torah said, Bereshit bara Elohim, in the beginning God created et, the heaven and earth. So what is the letter et? Should be written, Bereshit bara Elohim, Shamayim v'aretz. In the beginning God created heaven and earth. Why is et? So Kabbalah says, the Zohar says, et is the first letter of the Aleph Bet, Aleph, and the last letter, Taf. Yeah, because the basis of creation were Hebrew letters, the alphabet, from Aleph, from the first one, Aleph, to the last one, Taf. It's an important lecture, and showing you how Hebrew was the basis of everything, and definitely all depends on Torah. And keeping the Torah, keeping the mitzvahs, will bring us, hoping soon, to the third temple, and not bring us to a flood of fire, you know. Is it in flood of water? God said it will not be. But flood of fire can be. Look what is going on in California. So, let us repent, keep the Torah in its word, the Shabbos, purity of life, and then, hoping that soon, Messiah will come. The third temple will be built and peace, tranquility will be in the whole world. Mm-hmm.